Let's start with the Senate hearings. You described your initial assessment of the Maharlika Investment Fund is shaky at best and not well studied. What made you say that?
Well, to begin with, Karen, I asked them, the representative of the economic managers in the person of our national treasurer, Leia De Leon, what is the basic objective of the Maharlika bill? What do you seek to accomplish? Why are we doing this? A very basic question. The answer I got was that 50 other countries are doing it. So what do we want to do with it? She mentioned primarily infrastructure. Those in the House pushing for this also mentioned investments in infrastructure. And yet the bill filed in the Senate specifically excludes infrastructure. So I'm now in a quandary what purpose they have in establishing this fund. Now, Karen, this bill is being pushed by the administration. The president himself has endorsed it. The speaker has endorsed it. I would presume that they should have studied it, refined it before it was proposed to the Senate and the House. But apparently that's not the case.
Okay, Senator, now I'm confused because Congressman Joey Salceda on Head Start, when I asked what will the fund invest on? He gave the example of dams. That's infrastructure. That's not included?
Well, Karen, in the Senate version, it is not included. And now let's pursue that to its logical conclusion.
Yeah.
You got money from Land Bank and DBP. They're investing money to earn because they are banks. So Land Bank will contribute 50 billion, supposedly. DBP will contribute 25 billion, supposedly. Now, if you invest the 50 billion or 25 billion of Land Bank or DBP, respectively, in a dam, my question is, when will their ROI be? Asan yung ROI nila? Within the year, within 2 years, within 3 years, within 5 years? How will Banco Central look at that insofar as the balance sheet of both banks are concerned? Will they look the other way? That's not in the bill or in the measure as well. If you invested in a bridge, in a road, where is the ROI? If the private sector comes in and invests, they would expect a return on their investment. Now, when and how much and how will they quantify the return on investment if you spend that money, 100 billion supposedly, for infrastructure? These questions need to be answered and explained by the economic managers who are pushing for this bill.
Okay. First, does it break or violate the charter of the Land Bank and the DBP to put funds specifically in the Maharlika Investment Fund for the long term?
It does not violate the charter of Land Bank nor DBP. However, it would violate the capital regulatory requirements imposed by the Banco Central ng Pilipinas. For example, Karen, for the longest time, we've been trying to amend the charter of Land Bank and DBP to tell them, you should lend to agriculture in the agriculture sector because it represents 60% of our economy and the poorest of the poor Filipinos are in that sector.
Okay.
The basic argument of Banco Central with us for the past 12 years that I've been in the Senate before has been, no, we cannot allow that. We cannot allow these banks to put 70% of their loanable money in agriculture because it's like putting all of their eggs in one basket. If a typhoon hits, if a calamity hits, if disaster hits, then the banks might collapse. Now, insofar as the Maharlika Investment Fund is concerned, they're willing to look the other way. They're willing to say it's okay to invest 50 billion lock, stock, and barrel in one company. Now, if we're doing that, then why not look the other way too with respect to lending to agriculture? The president seems to be giving significant importance to the agriculture sector, given that he has retained secretaryship of the Department of Agriculture. Then why not order Land Bank and DBP to lend to the agri sector in order to modernize the agri sector? Mas diretso pa to, Karen. Hindi yung dadaan sa Maharlika Fund, i-invest pa sa kung saan. Ito, diretsong loan window na para sa agriculture, to modernize agriculture, to alleviate the poverty-stricken sector in agriculture that farmers and fisher folk have been suffering under for the past so many decades.
So you're seeing a double standard there of some sort.
Well, definitely. In fact, in the own position paper of Land Bank and DBP, they specifically ask that they be exempted from the capital regulatory requirements of BSP. Otherwise, they won't be able to do this. Now, remember, Karen, the Secretary of Finance sits in the Monetary Board. Mm-mm. You also have to remember the Secretary of Finance sits as chairman of Land Bank. Why were these not threshed out before reaching the Senate? These should have been clarified and threshed out before the bill was even filed or reached the Senate.